Welcome to Jimmy Bowen and Friends. Each week's episode features Jimmy Bowen and a special guest like Radney Foster, J.D. Shelburne, Darren and Brooke Aldridge, and more. Today's guest is Keith Anderson. Now, here's Jimmy Bowen.
Well, I've got a gal that's sweet to me. She just ain't what she used to be. She's a little hard-headed, that's plain to see. Don't get it by me reasons down to earth with me. Now looky here, gal, don't you holler at me. I ain't forgot what you used to be. When you didn't have nothing, that's plain to see. Don't get it by me reasons down to earth with me. Raise your head so high every time you pass me by, cause it didn't mean nothing to me, you see. Don't get it by me reason, stay down to earth with me. Now looky here, gotta better be yourself, leave that other stuff on the shelf. You're a country baby, oh, that's plain to see. Don't get it by me reason, stay down to earth with me. A little high-headed, that's plain to see. Don't get it by me reason, sit down to earth with me.
And welcome to the show. We have a great night of music for you guys. Our guest tonight is a singer-songwriter, great performer, and what a writer. You're going to love his songs that he has written and that he does. We have got Keith Anderson tonight coming to visit with us. We're looking forward to that. And you guys hang out for a little bit. We'll be right back after these messages. And see you shortly.
There's more Jimmy Bowen and Friends coming up right after this short break. Welcome back to Jimmy Bowen and Friends.
Well, thank you, and welcome back to the show. Tonight's guest we have for you guys is a tremendous artist and a songwriter. And this guy is out on the road doing his thing, and what an entertainer he is. Please make welcome Mr. Keith Anderson. Hey, it's good to have you here, man.
Good to be here.
I like your shirt.
It's yeah, cool. We're matching.
Yeah, we'd be a band. Well, listen, tell us a little bit about it. You've become a successful writer, successful artist. So which do you prefer? Which is really trips your trigger, so to speak?
Well, they're just both different. I love the when you write a great song and you know it's a great song and you work so hard on just the craft of putting it together and not just the rhymes, but making sure that it says what you want to say. And because you write every day and you try to write as much as you can, and to write a good song, that happens a lot in Nashville, but when you really nail one, and if it's, especially if somebody else wants to record it, that's probably the highest honor when another artist wants to record something you've written. So that's awesome. But I, coming from an athletic background, I probably still prefer that the stage. It's like the adrenaline. The adrenaline, the feedback, and the whole process of doing a live show. I love that.
Well, you can't beat a live show. Well, with the songwriting you've done, who are some of the artists that you've written for? A lot of people, I've always found it intriguing that a lot of artists that do these great songs, you never meet the writer. You never know who does that.
And so, I was one of the guys that I just was charged by songwriting early on. So I had a habit, this will date me, but back when I first buy the cassette, I would take the J card out. And I always wanted to know who the writers were and who the session players were. And it's funny because you move to Nashville and you know these names of these great session players and great songwriters, but you don't have a clue what they look like. So you could see them every day and not know. And as you start, you know, if you're lucky enough to start meeting them and getting to know them and write with them and work with them, it's really cool to see those names and faces come together. So I've always loved that part of it and just being a songwriting junkie. So that was a big part of me moving to Nashville, wanting to become a writer first. So I've been able to write songs for wrote Beer Run for Garth Brooks and George Jones, and Lost in This Moment for Big and Rich, and I've got songs on Gretchen Wilson's records and Neil McCoy and some other people.
That's great. Give him a hand. That's an accomplishment in itself, you know. Now this song. Tell us about the song that's off your second project, right?
I Still Miss You.
Mm-hmm.
So tell us a little bit about that song.
Well, it's I tell people that's kind of the power of music. Is it was written. I wrote that with Jason Sellers and Tim Nichols, and we got together and just the first time we'd written together. So you always try to get to know each other, and just in that process. Jason says, you know, your song, Every Time I Hear Your Name, helped me get through a heart breakup. And he started talking about it. And at that moment, we're like, you know, well, let's write that. So this song was originally written just about a breakup. And then as we go into the studio and start putting stuff together, Jeffrey Steele produced both my records, the first two records. And at that point, it was just a different vibe because he just lost his 13-year-old son in a four-wheeler accident. I just found out a couple months earlier that my mom had terminal brain cancer. And that song just took a whole nother meaning for us and the whole project. And so by the time we put that out, we were getting calls from radio saying, man, this is really touching people that, you know, have gone through a breakup, but also people that have lost sons and daughters in the war and different, just all kind of, we started seeing the how far that song could go and music in general. And so by the time we put the video out, it's a tribute to my mom who just passed away.
Now you're going to do that for us tonight, right?
Yeah, I'd love to.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Keith Anderson.
I changed the presets in my truck so those old songs don't sneak up. Still find me, remind me, yeah, you come back that easy. Try restaurants I've never been to, order new things off the menu. Never tried, cause you didn't lie, but two drinks in and you're by my side. I've talked to friends, talked to myself, talked to God, I pray like hell. So deep down in my soul, I feel helpless, so hopeless. It's a door that never closes. nor don't know how to do this. I've talked to friends, talked to myself, talked to God, I pray like hell, and I still miss you. I've tried sober, I've tried drinking, I've been strong and I've been weak, and I still miss you. I've done
Jimmy Bowen and Friends will be right back. Welcome back to Jimmy Bowen and Friends.
Keith, that was great, man.
Thank you.
What a song.
Thanks. I love the way you pour that feeling in the heart into that song.
Thank you.
Of course,
thank
I know you. It has a lot of meaning to you, so that...
Yeah, that's one of those where it's kind of my moment on stage each night with my mom. I can still kind of feel her presence.
What a great song.
Thank you. Thanks. Well,
everybody's looking for that record deal.
Yeah.
So with you, do you feel more in control when you do it on your own versus dealing with the labels? Are you more comfortable that way? Or
well,
what's your opinion?
Well, certainly have a lot more ability to pick the songs you want and really put the project together that you want. And that, you know, the songwriter, the people working on with you, the producers, you have a lot more flexibility. I'm not going to lie, it's great to have a record label out there helping push stuff on the radio and with that big power machine that goes on behind it.
Yeah.
But, you know, there's good and bad to both. I mean, there's a lot of things you don't get your way that much, you know. So it's, you know, it's good both ways. But this has been fun putting this project together and just being able to do what we want to do.
Yeah. Well, Picking on the Wildflowers. Tell us about that. That was a song that people still want to hear. That's an older song, is it not?
That's the very first single I had, yeah.
Very first single that you had. People love to hear it, don't they?
We were lucky on that one. I wrote that with John Rich and Kim Williams, and it was the first time we'd written together. And John brought that riff in. It just had that swampy, dirty feel.
Yeah.
And we were just talking about how they're, you know, it was such a, there's so much on the radio that was just so politically correct at the time. And we're like, man, where's the old, you know, Conway Twitty, hello, darling. I mean, you knew what he was talking about
right,
when he started
right.
singing. And so many great songs back then that were just to the point. And we're like, let's just write something fun that, you know, we can disguise what we're saying, but everybody kind of knows
right.
with a wink and a nod what you're really
so
saying.
So is that what makes the song special to you? That is kind of...
It's special. It's one of those you dream of because, A, it was my first single, and it's my fourth biggest hit, but it's still the one everybody remembers and the one everybody, it's the biggest reaction live.
Yeah.
But it was one of those that you got all three things you dream about in a song, a melody of a song that people want to sing, a title that's really cool, and then that opening guitar riff that is just unforgettable. That it really is the minute that guitar riff starts, everybody knows it, and you just dream of having songs like that.
Well, there you go. You're going to do it for us, right?
I'll do it. Yeah, absolutely.
Make welcome again, Mr. Keith Anderson, ladies and gentlemen.
Meet me down at the railroad tracks. I got Tom Petty playing in my Silverado and a ice down a six pack. Ow, ow. Hey Daisy, don't you worry about your mama. Like 007, we can keep it covert. Undercover on the ground by the water. Gotta get a little peace on earth. I say, baby, won't you see me go picking my flowers. Got a spot way back in the woods. Sneak away for a couple of hours. You and me, baby, picking my flowers. Like a cherry tree, let's buzz around, maybe do some pollinating. Yeah, dive in like honeybees. Ah, baby, won't you see me go picking wildflowers? Got a spot way back in the woods. Sneak away for a couple of hours, you and me, baby. I'm picking wildflowers.
With more Jimmy Bowen and Friends in just a moment. Welcome back to Jimmy Bowen and Friends.
Well, welcome back, folks. What did you think of Keith Anderson? Woo, man. Wouldn't you hate to meet him in a dark alley? Woo, Lord. He put a can of you know what on you, wouldn't he? Well, I tell you what, I love Keith. He's a great writer and a great performer. We appreciate you folks being with us tonight, and we're going to end our portion of the show with an old song, an old country song written by Willie Nelson years ago, and we hope that you enjoy it. You guys hang out with us and see you next time around.
In the rain.
can see.